David is the managing partner of the fund. I am the largest investor in the fund. So I have a huge vested interest in the success of the fund. But unlike David, who has to run a fund and be a fiduciary, I get to just go in and help entrepreneurs, which is all I want to do. And so I doubt there are many other managing partners of a fund like David would ever let me carve out my role. But I only do what I enjoy doing, which is helping entrepreneurs.
So David, your current fund is in $35 million, and there's a rumor that you're raising a $400 million fund. Is that an accurate rumor?
Well, I mean, we're exploring all options. We're exploring all options.
That's a lot different than what's going on with the mayor. Okay. Okay, so wait, no, let's get a little further. I've got a couple questions out of the way. Sorry, so here's one. At the Crunchies earlier this year, so was that you told a story about that very cool driving. I'm just curious, how did that happen? Like, what were you thinking when you said that? Why is she, you know?
I was drunk at the time. So.
The story was about how tenacious she is and also her good guess is Julie. Was she actually drunk?
She's also a big driver.
I tweeted about that. It's actually the first time I sort of put a big question mark on it. Mike Moore, you know, the amazing staff, you know, this is a mistake, taking a step back for another disease. I know that you've known him for decades now.
Yes.
How many of us have been that long or that well? I'd love for you to just talk a little bit about, you know, what he's done for Silicon Valley, what it is that right around his ear, what it is that, you know.
Yeah. So if you go all the way back to the 70s, I was an entrepreneur myself, and I was a computer company that I co-founded.
What is that?
It was a microcomputer company,
yeah.
Even before the IBM PC. So great year, well, back in the 70s. And back in the 70s, Don Valentine, the founder of Sequoia, was one of the very iconic VCs in Silicon Valley. And Don Valentine and Sequoia were investors in Altos.
Yeah.
Don Valentine is really the guy that we started angel investing after Altos went public. And I had net worth and said, hey, why don't we start investing in some of these companies with us?
Yeah.
So what I'm really saying is I knew my parts the day he started at Sequoia. Every new partner that came on, Don Valentine introduced me to them and I started working with them. The highlight for Mike Mortis and I is the day I introduced Mike Mortis to Google. And Mike Mortis was on the Google board for many years and added massive amounts of value and his intelligence to Google. But not just to Google, but to probably a couple of other companies where Mike Mortis has had a massive impact. He will continue to have that impact. Here's a guy who is definitely an icon for all of tech, but a great example because he is so humble. But anyone who's had Mike Moritz on the board knows here's one of really a wise man that will help an entrepreneur on any project. He has some of the best judgment, you know, that I've ever seen. And I hope a lot of entrepreneurs get to work with him going forward.
If you look back at the giants of venture capital in our lifetimes, and if you look at Moritz and Gore, the first two names that come to mind, for me, do you agree?
Yes.
Yeah, I mean, do you choose one or the other? Are they both just, you know, sort of just making you, you know?
That's an awkward question.
No, I'm just saying, but I know that, again, I'm going to do a new eulogy here, both these guys are so awkward, but just if you look back at the different styles, I mean, what's the best in Silicon Valley? Who's given the most, who's had the most success?
Yeah, everyone has different values and styles.
Yeah.
Google did the best job. Larry and Sergey handpicked John Doerr and Mike Moritz to be on their board. That tells you how smart Larry is. So definitely both. And 13 years ago, the founders of Google were smart enough to say, we're going to go get the two icons. But look at people like Bill Draper, even before them.
Sure.
Yeah, there's some great icons in the investment.
David, Beckwith, Richard Horowitz called me was lazy last week. I'm actually sort of paraphrasing. But what do you think he was talking about? This is like the number of the scout deals, the story of Panther Daily. We had that sort of quote where it's on angels don't add value. I mean, what do you think about that? What did he mean? And what do you think, you know, about that?
You know, I'm not sure what he meant.
Do you think angels are super lazy?
No, I think all investors add value in different ways. I think there are some investors who try to get really active in companies. There are some investors who take a more service-oriented approach. There are some investors.
So you've been investing in every YC company now for over a year. One, two, three boxes now, right? Because we're taking all the smart fund with your building now, so you're doing it on your own. Do you have any more information?
No, it's still called smart funds. Okay. And, right now it's Yuri Milner, Felix, and increasing us.
It's like 150.
Okay,
so you're giving $50,000 on every single YC. Is
yeah.
That right? Okay, so how's that working out on the spreadsheet? Is it look like a good, I mean, I know it's to some extent it was an experiment. Does it look like a good investment?
I mean, it's too early to tell. There's a lot of numbers that, you know, on paper it's looking great, but like a lot of these are, and they do financing, and so you mark it up. And
so what's the book value of that now? Is it up?
It's still probably really sick, but it's not. I mean, I think about companies like Apple. I mean, they're a startup company. That's the company that's on Kickstarter right now.
Yeah.
I think there's something, there's an 8 million sales. And we met there and really liked it. We just said, hey, we told them straight up, we want to encourage you to invest in something like this.
Yeah.
You're going to laugh. This company is just on fire. So that's a great example for us, startup.
So you're glad that you're doing it.
Yeah.
I mean, it's because there's so many more companies now. There's 63 in the last month.
Yes.
Although you decreased your investment size because you gave more than 50% more.
We can do that.
Oh, that's right. I never gave it to
you.
Okay. So do you think you want to keep doing this over the long run?
Yes. All
right.
YC is a great center.
Yeah. Yeah. What's the trend right now in terms of payments?
Yeah, I mean, what we're seeing, and I think TechCrunch wrote about this earlier, and Ron talked about it, maybe again, it's just the commerce is being, the way people are buying stuff is changing.
What's the main thing?
Ron spoke at Mayor was a big TechCrunch.
John Orthodox.
Yeah. And if you just see the way people are buying stuff is changing. So for the first time ever, for some people, it's why our shop online and offline. So you see companies like Pinterest, Warby Parker, everything. Those are ways of you sort of digest the content, you buy the stuff, you create relationships with your hardcore transaction. I think that's a good thing. There are different ways. We've talked as well about online to offline commerce, just closing the payment loop here. And we still think that's a huge one.
And another big trend is the sharing economy. Airbnb being, you know, a bunch of challenges that have held probably hundreds of companies in this sector. And they'll be able to get distribution and commerce from the world. But the gift that Facebook has given the industry is distribution. And OpenGraph, we think it's going to have a huge impact. And there'll be tons of startups that take advantage of that. Social cam being a vivid example.
Are you guys investors in social care? Are you guys bidding? Anything else here?
Well, just to say the peer-to-peer commerce area, what peer-to-peer sharing, I think, comes out of Stitch here in New York. Just the idea that you don't need to be a part of the institution. An institution in order to provide a service. I think that whole idea of institutions being less important in terms of commercializing themselves, I think, is a pretty important.
Guys, anything else you want to say?
Yeah, basically.
You want to know if you can't see from there in San Francisco?
That's not going to happen. So all the entrepreneurs in the room, read Zuckerberg's letter to the shareholders. And there's the longest paragraph, appropriately so, talks about the hack culture of Facebook. And if I was starting a company today, I would subscribe to the hack culture. It's a great way of building.